Let's all shake off those winter blues with the Blue Team.
Hi, my name's Zoe, and we're presenting Talon, a utility knife that retracts before skin contact to prevent injuries. Here is an experienced construction worker. Just like all construction workers, he has his utility knife, a versatile tool he uses to score drywall, plastic, or wood. He's been scoring drywall all day, and although this may seem like a harmless task, even an experienced worker can incur quite significant injuries. Out of the many construction workers we spoke to, a very experienced construction manager told us that he had been cut over 50 times from his utility knife. In fact, there are over 500 injuries from utility knives in the U.S. every day. This is why we developed Talon, a utility knife that retracts to prevent injury. Now, Malik has Talon. He turns Talon on by sliding the blade out with the traditional thumb slider. When the blade is out, an LED illuminates. Now Malik starts cutting. As you can see, he scores his drywall just as he would with a traditional utility knife. But this time, watch what happens when Malik slips. The blade retracts into the housing. Let's slow it down and watch that again at 6,400 frames per second. Talon senses skin and immediately retracts. Talon is able to sense through gloves and light clothing in order to prevent injuries all over the body. Malik quickly resets his blade and continues working. If a worker needs to strip wires or cut conductive materials, they can simply disengage the safety by pushing a button in the back. Additionally, there are over drywallers need to replace their blades more than 10 times a day. This is why we added a blade replacement feature, so our workers could replace their blades quickly and easily. And Malik is done for the day. He puts Talon back in the charger. It will be fully charged within 1 hour. Now, I'm going to hand it off to Jorge, who will tell you exactly how Talon works.
One of our core design requirements was that Talon be able to use standard trapezoid-shaped utility blades. From there, we then had to design a tool that construction workers would actually want to use, something that looked, felt, and functioned like a regular utility knife, but could still house all of our important electrical, mechanical, and sensing components. But before we get into that, let's take a closer look at the blade retraction. As soon as your finger comes into close proximity with the blade, Talon knows to retract the blade into the housing. It does this by using capacitive sensing via an integrated sensing circuit connected to the blade. As soon as something conductive, such as your finger, comes into close proximity with the blade, our device triggers and the blade is retracted into the housing. This whole process happens extremely quickly. Our total retraction time from first sensing to full retraction is 24 milliseconds. That's 10 times faster than the blink of an eye. Now, some of you may have noticed, when our blade retracts, it doesn't do so in a linear motion. This was a very intentional design choice. By rotating the blade as we retract it, we avoid creating a sawing motion with the sharp lower edge of the blade, something that could potentially make cuts even worse. Inside of our housing, the blade sits in a small blade carriage. This carriage sits in between two plates that both constrain the blade and guide it as it retracts via a series of guide rails. These plates also house many of our important mechanical and electrical components, including our custom printed circuit board, our solenoid, which we use for mechanical actuation, and a small spring, which we use to retract the blade and carriage. Our quick release system was one of our most critical components because the retraction speed depended heavily on it. This is where the lever arms, mounted on either side of the plates and highlighted in blue here, come in. These lever arms were based off gun sears, the quick release method in many firearms. These lever arms are able to withstand the full cutting force transferred to the device when it is in use, but can quickly rotate out of the way, allowing the blade and carriage to retract into the device. This entire subassembly was made such that it can slide forwards and backwards in the housing using a button on the top of the housing, just like a regular utility knife. This sliding function also serves as our reset mechanism. After Talon has been triggered and the blade carriage has been retracted into the device, the backwards motion of the plates forces the blade carriage forward using a small feature on the housing. After it's forced forward, the lever arms lock it into place. To continue using Talon, simply use the button on the top of it to slide this entire assembly forward, and Talon is ready to be for continual use. Now that you've seen how our patent-pending mechanism works, I'm going to hand it over to Mo, who's going to talk a little bit more about how we're going to bring Talon to market.
With Talon, we will break into the $300 million construction utility knife market. We will differentiate Talon from other utility knives on the market by providing two core values to our end users. First, every single time a construction worker picks up Talon, they will be secure in the fact that they cannot hurt themselves with our product the same way they would with another utility knife. Furthermore, from our user research, we have found that every utility knife injury comes with an associated cost, which drops productivity in the workplace. With Talon, we will deliver a safer and more productive worksite to all our users. That being said, Talon and its individual charger will have a retail price combined of $50. Let me explain to you how we got there. We begin with the cost. At production scale, it will cost us $12 to create Talon and its charger. When we sell to big box retailers, we will be giving them a $30 wholesale price, giving us an $18 gross margin. And then they will sell Talon and its charger for $50. However, we don't plan on just selling through retail. We hope to go through e-commerce channels. And when we do that with our own website, we will take the retail markup for ourselves, leaving us a gross margin of $38. With a $750,000 investment, we believe we can launch Talon as a viable business, becoming profitable in our third year. This will only take us less than 2% of the construction utility knife market, so we are confident in our goals. That being said, we believe our product has applications beyond just construction. We see Talon being a useful tool in factories where repair and maintenance officers have to use utility knives to perform regular fixes on the day-to-day, and in various logistics centers for companies like Amazon, where workers have to open boxes with utility knives for countless hours. As we spread our product, Talon, past just construction to a variety of markets, we believe that we'll be able to create a world where everyone can cut with confidence. Thank you.
Okay, well, we go this way. Thank you, Blue Team. Again, raise your hand if you have a question, or you can post it to Twitter. We'll start up front right here.
Hey, guys. Great work. So you mentioned that the retract time for the knife is 24 milliseconds. I guess I wasn't sure, how do you know that that's fast enough to retract to guarantee that you don't cut the skin? So for example, if you're cutting, say, at like a foot per second, 250 millimeters per second, that's the blade will travel about 6 millimeters in the retraction time.
Question was around, how do you know you're not going to cut your finger off?
Yeah, so currently we can't promise that we know how deep that the blade's gonna cut. It is dependent on how fast the blade is traveling during the accident and also how fast our retraction time is. So we assure you that in the future, our biggest priority is to decrease that retraction time.
Thank you. I have a question from Twitter that says, "Hey, Blue Team, great product. Construction sites are rough places. How did you test Talon for durability, dust, and water?"
So our current version of Talon is not water and dust proof, but in the future we plan to put coatings on our circuit boards to make it more waterproof. And we found through testing that our sensing is relatively accurate through water too.
Great, thank you. Question over here.
So I want to follow up on the testing question because I believe you did a lot of testing that did not involve Malik's finger, perhaps involving hot dogs. Could you describe a little bit of the process of that? And in particular, I'm interested in statistics and how often did it actually cut the hot dog or whatever the sample was? How often did it not? I'd really like to know how reliable it is at retracting.
Can you share some statistics around how frequently the blade retracted successfully?
Yeah, so we did a lot of early testing with hot dogs, but not so much recently. So we don't have those statistics currently. So within its current prototype state, we weren't able to test it enough to give you a clear statistic.
Future work.
Yes.
Question over there.
Hi, hello. So how long is the lifetime on this knife before it runs out? Because let's say my money matters right now. So if I have to wait an hour for it to charge, that's less money I get. And second, also, if I'm a construction worker, like how portable is the charger?
Great question about the charger. How long does the charge last and can you move the charger around?
So the charge for Talon lasts over 2 days and the charging time is around 45 minutes. There are charging stations in construction sites along with all the other power tools that the construction workers use. And so this would be part of that's on the construction site.
Thank you. Last question over here.
Great. Hi, thanks for the presentation. I was wondering if you could talk a little bit more about the current market and how much the average utility knife costs today and then the value that you would get with the $50 utility knife.
Yeah, so the premium utility knives on the market today cost anywhere between $10 and $15. We price it at $50 because that represents the current markup for a tech-enabled or safety-enabled hand tool or power tool. And then also interviews with construction companies, they're actually pretty price inelastic. And the general contractors and subcontractors can tell their employees which tools to buy in certain scenarios. And so we still think that our $50 price point is definitely reachable for the average construction worker.
Thank you, Blue Team.